how we can handle patients and manage them effectively in OPD as well as in OT. Most of the points have been covered in Dr. Ajay Durrani's lecture, so I'll be briefing on them. The first and the foremost one is the personal protection. All the staff who is managing the OPD will be insisted to wear a proper N95 mask. And it is a routine in our center that we issue 6 fresh masks every month to them, each individual staff. And the same can be sterilized by ETO over the weekend. And on top of it, we advise them to wear a 3-ply mask. And the face shield and the PPE kit both need to be worn only by the staff who is at the entry point. And the receptionist will have to use a face shield in addition to the mask. And the gloves are given for all the staff. Alcohol-based sanitizers are installed at strategic points for use by patients as well as the staff. So what are the modifications we require from a routine OPD practice? The consultation should be preferably given by appointment only, and walk-ins have to be avoided so that we can streamline the patient flow and avoid overcrowding. And the appointment slots in the early hours in the morning are to be reserved for elderly and patients with comorbidities so that they spend less time in OPD. And only one attendant is allowed for a frail patient or in case of minors. Patients in with history of fever, cough, or any contact with a positive patient have should be redirected to the physician first. And patients have already got an appointment, but they develop fever or other symptoms, can be rescheduled at a later date for consultation. And declaration is obtained from each patient and attendant along with the one ID proof. And it is also made sure that Arogya Setu app is downloaded and on patients and the mobiles of the staff. And continuing with the structural modification, we have to ensure that the entry point is single, where the temperature check can be done and other history can be asked, and hand sanitization is also done. The rooms are well ventilated, as already discussed in detail, and the seating arrangements are spaced out. No-touch hand sanitizers are installed at strategic points like near footwear storage, washrooms, and cash handling areas. And we have talked in brief about in detail about the UV light. So this need to be used in the waiting area and the consultation rooms as well. So this can be used intermittently during OPD hours, like when patients are not there, and at the end of the day, which can be left overnight. And posters and snippets which showcase the precautions to be undertaken, sanitization procedures, and proper mask usage and social distancing protocols such as these are displayed at prominent points in the patient waiting area. And as already discussed, the airflow should be in such a way that it is directed from behind the consultant, the doctor, which is then flowing towards the patients. And then the side room, which has an exhaust fan, will be removing this air. And then there is a chance of fresh air, which is being exchanged. And the staff education is also very, very important. They should be made aware of all the change in the protocols that are being formulated. And they are advised to schedule appointments with a time gap between two patients so as the OPD and the waiting area can be sanitized. And they should also be educated about the frequent hand sanitization to be done in between patients. And at the entry point, the staff who is in charge is instructed to check for appropriate usage of masks. As in patients coming, whatever mask they're using, it is to be taped at the nose part. And if a patient is wearing a cloth mask, then they have to be given a 3-ply mask to wear above it. And in case of children whom the mask will be not fitting very properly, then it has to be either tied or looped behind the ear. And the attenders are also to be advised not to maintain distancing and not to touch anywhere unnecessarily. And the staff who is there in charge of the cash handling, he needs to be doubly careful and sanitized after each transaction. When it comes to OPD procedures, routine contact procedures are to be avoided. And after refraction, the frame and the instrument head, chin rests are cleaned with 100% spirit between patients. And direct ophthalmoscopy is to be avoided completely and 90T also to the extent possible. And home dilation where feasible is advised to the patients as well as for ROP babies. And UV chamber is, as shown in the picture, is used for sterilizing occluder, 20 diopter lens and depressor. And slit lamp shield has also been talked about. And it is mandatory. And investigations such as fields, topography are to be given appointment at a later date. Coming to the OT protocols, the procedures are to be restricted for emergencies, such as lens-induced glaucoma, trauma-related procedures, and intraocular foreign body, retinal detachment, endophthalmitis treatment, intravitreal injections in one-eyed patients, or fresh AMD cases. Cataract surgeries and other elective surgeries like secondary IOL, SOR, ERM are to be deferred at present. Intravitreal injection, the patient can be given advice on choosing long-acting agents that can reduce the number of visits for the patient. Wherever possible, the general anesthesia is to be avoided as it is aerosol-generating procedure because of the intubation. And if it is unavoidable, then the patient has to be properly investigated with a complete blood count, CRP, RT-PCR test, and CT chest and X-ray. And the patient movement should be streamlined with no unnecessary delays. If the patient is a COVID negative, routine workflow with no delays are to be ensured, and minimum personnel are need to be present in the OT, and personal protection are to be used. Again, the patient has to be taped over the mask, and it's always preferable to have a laminar flow which can avoid the patient's breathing being directed towards the staff. And for GA, face shield is to be used by the anesthetist, and laryngeal mask airway is preferred over uncuffed endotracheal tube intubation. If the patient is positive, then he need to be taken only in dire emergency. And again, bare minimum staff have to be in OT. HEPA filter with UV and laminar flow is a must. The patient should also be wearing an N95 mask, which is again tape. And they should spend minimum time in OT. This can be ensured by keeping the OT trolley ready and the surgeon also scrubbed when the patient has to be shifted. And PPE kit is worn prior to gowning, and as much as possible, GA is to be avoided. This is a modification we did in our center, which is actually a half PPE. That is, the PPE is used for the lower half of the body, whereas the surgical gown covers the upper body. And Schlieren imaging studies have shown that in a patient who had used the mask properly with sealed mask, the air currents going upwards is minimal, so that aerosol discharge is minimal. And as much importance is to be given for cleaning the OT after the procedure in any suspected uninvestigated case of patients or in positive patients, these scrubbing and gown removal procedure are very important. And after removal of the gown also, scrubbing is to be repeated. And the UV light is used for sterilization at least for 2 to 3 hours. And fogging needs to be done where laminar flow or HVAC is not available. And the terminal surface cleaning is also to be ensured. Thank you for your kind attention and stay safe.